Hello all. Today I am reviewing Orphan Train Girl. It is the young reader's edition of the Orphan Train book by Christina Baker Klein. When I think of an orphan, the first image that comes to mind is Little Orphan Annie. An 11-year-old feisty red-haired orphan who has been placed under the care of the very inebriated Miss Hannigan. Annie seems doomed for a hard-knock life. But everything changes when Grace Kelly, a secretary to billionaire Oliver Warbucks, walks into the orphanage. Miss Kelly selects one lucky orphan, Annie, to celebrate Christmas with the Warbucks. Annie is whisked away from the slums of the Lower East Side of NYC and brought to a mansion on the ritzy side of the city, Fifth Avenue. Set during dark times in America, the Great Depression, Annie's ending is anything but dismal. Just as America gets a new deal to help our economy, Little Orphan Annie gets one too. Unfortunately, not every orphan is fated to have a life like Annie. Although Annie is a fictitious character, orphanages were a reality of our past. From the years 1854 to 1929, there were trains that transported orphans from the eastern United States to the Midwest. When the train stopped, the children would line up to be scrutinized and selected by men and women that they had never before met. These strangers were to become their new families. The young reader's edition of the novel Orphan Train Girl by Christina Baker Klein tells two tales. One of Vivian, a 91-year-old orphan train rider from 1929, and the other of Molly, a 12-year-old child in foster care during the present day in Maine. It is fate that brings Vivian and Molly together. Vivian has never disclosed her heart-wrenching story to anyone, as most people could never really understand what she went through. Similarly, Molly does not like talking about her past, as most kids wouldn't understand what she has gone through. The only people that Vivian and Molly could ever identify with before meeting each other were the characters in books. This is why Molly steals a torn-up copy of the book, The Secret Garden, from the library. When her foster parents find out what she has done, they are livid with her. It is decided that Molly will do 20 hours of community service for her misdeed at Vivian's home. For the next few weeks, Molly helps the 91-year-old Vivian to clean her attic. When Vivian meets Molly, there is an instant connection. Vivian sees herself in Molly. While working together to reorganize the attic, Vivian begins to tell her own story as each object, memory from the past, is pulled from a box one by one. Talking to Vivian helps Molly to come to terms with her past and learn to move forward in life. Talking to Molly about her past helps Vivian to finally come to terms with all that she has been through since the age of 9. The loss of her family, the shuffling from home to home, and the unknown of what was to come. By the end of the novel, Vivian allows Molly to share her difficult past for the first time with others. Molly uses all Vivian has told her to complete a history portaging project on Vivian's orphan train journey. The young reader's edition of Orphan Train Girl is fast-paced and written in a most unique style. Baker has chosen to combine first-person perspective with third-person. Vivian's story, written in first-person perspective, allows the reader to form a connection with her 9-year-old and 91-year-old self. Hearing the story directly from Vivian lets us understand why this elderly woman is going to take a liking to Molly. Molly's character is a little distant and untrustworthy of others due to her experiences in the foster care system. Molly does not like sharing information about herself with her foster care parents, kids at school, or teachers. She prefers to keep to herself because she is the only person that she can rely on. I believe that third person limited is the perspective that is perfect for her story, as we're limited to only hearing Molly's viewpoint through a third person narrator. The third person limited viewpoint distances itself from hearing other views. This is fitting for Molly's guarded character, who doesn't just let anyone into her world. She distances herself from hearing other characters. It is only towards the end of the novel that we see Molly has let Vivian into her life. I absolutely loved Orphan Train Girl, the Young Readers Edition, and I give it 5 out of 5 stars. I hope you read it.